Hey all, welcome again on Davis Tech. So this is a part 4 video of the model classes, and we will work on sending a data from the front end to the back end. So let me go on a model.dart file, which file we created on a first video, very first video, and I told you that we need a two method. First method is from JSON. That method is responsible for fetching a data from the back end and showing that data on our front end. And there is a second method called toJSON, which we not use yet on any video. So this toJSON method is responsible for sending the data from the front end to the back end. So we will use this toJSON method for sending some data from the front end to the back end. So this video is for single instance. So basically in the first video, what we did that we get a single instance called name and phone number from the back end. Similarly, in this video, what I will show that how we can send a single instance name and phone number from the Flutter app to the backend. So this video for the single instance only. In the next coming video, what I will show that how we can send a list type of object to the front end to the backend. Suppose right now we get a 6 object from the backend to the front end. But what if I want to send a 6 object or any dynamic object, I mean list of object, from the front end Flutter app to the back end? How we will do that, we will see on the next coming video. But in this video, I will show you that how we can send a single object which contain a name and phone number from a front end to the back end with help of this toJSON method. So I didn't show you that how we can send it through the toJSON, so I thought that I can make a video for a single instance only for the first time, then we will go for the multiple instance. So basically in the last video we got a list of data from the backend, and maybe the color and all the orientation was not same. I made changes on a main.dart file that I created a app container class where I put the my app class which we created in our very first video. So here is the my app class. So all the code which we created till now in third video is pasted inside the my app.dart file, and in the main.dart file is now clean. So basically what you have to do is go on a description and find a repo link. Then you can understand what are the changes I make. I will show you that how we can use a toJSON method in this video. So let me go over there. So basically what I will do that I will create a new file. So suppose the file name is add data. In add data, what I will do that I will create two text form fields. Let me import the material.dart package, and I will create a stateful widget. Again, I am using a awesome Flutter snippet for creating a widget. So name will be app data, and it will return a scaffold. Let me return a scaffold widget, and in the scaffold we have a body parameter. So the body will have basically a column widget, or we can use a list view also. In the column what we have is children. Inside the children we can use a text form field. So let me create a text form field. This is a first text form field. Then we will use the size box height, and height will be like 10, and again there will be another text form field. So I will not do any kind of styling here. I will just want to show you that how we can use the toJSON method. And in the text form field we have a decoration. I will use the input decoration, inside the input declaration, what we have label text. So let me write a label text name, and same thing we will do over here. I will just copy it and I will use on a second text form field. So it will be a phone number, and you know that for the text form field we use a controller that is a text edit controller. So let me initialize a text edit controller for these two text form field. First one will be phone. I will initialize it. Second one will be name. So basically I'm just doing something on a UI part, then I will show you how we can send it. So text edit controller, its name. The text edit controller phone will be used inside the phone. So we have a controller. I will assign a phone over here. For the name, I will assign inside the name text form field controller name and hit the save. Go on a main.dart file. Instead of my app, which is a this widget, I will use the add data. Let me use the add data. Let me check the name. App data. App data. So the name should be add data, but I use as a add data. So basically I have to import it. Okay, now I imported it. I will hit the save. Then I will get a two text form field over there. And let me go on a column. Inside the column we have a main axis alignment. And in the main axis alignment, I will do main axis alignment center. Hit the save. Now it's come on a center. We can do the padding also if you want to show it little good. So I will use just symmetric. All the time I use symmetric because symmetric have a horizontal. Let me initialize the horizontal. With help of that we will pad left and right. Now it's looking something good. I can do it 15. Now after providing a name and phone number, we need a button also to submit this phone number. So just below the text form field, what I will do, I will use a size box with the height to get a padding like 10, and there I will create a container. Otherwise I can use a flat button. So inside a flat button we have a two thing, on press and child. So on press will be empty right now, and inside the child we can use text add data. Hit the save and you will see the here the button is came, but let me provide some color to look good. Colors dot till. So the button came here. I can do that. I can add some padding. So I am not focusing on the UI. I just focusing on the part of two JSON method. So let me create a function. The function I will pass over here, which will be responsible for the sending a data from the front end to the back end. So the function will be void send, and it will be a sync and await type. So basically we need a package called HTTP. So the HTTP package name, I can get it from here, and we added that package inside the pubspec.yaml file if you watch the first video, and now here we can make a HTTP request. So let me show you that how we will make a HTTP request. I will show you a Postman. So this is an endpoint which will be responsible for sending a data from the front end to the back end, and in this endpoint, in the body, we will send a name and phone number. So this is the name and phone number I showed you, and if I will click on a send, then we will get a response. The response contains a message that profile added successfully, and the data which we send from the front end, and it will store on a MongoDB database, which will generate a ID with the name and phone number. So this response we will get after we will get a successfully response as a status code 200. So let me go on a Flutter project, and here I will use word response. Okay, and we will use await and HTTP, and here we have a post method. In a post method, we have to provide a URL which is an endpoint. So for our case, endpoint is this. You can get this endpoint code on the GitHub repo which I provide on a GitHub on a description. And before sending data, we have to use the model class. So the model class which I created over here, let me close the, all the other. This model class will be responsible for sending a name and phone number to the backend. So you know that first we need to create an instance of the model class. So I will create a model instance which is a model and model. So let me create an instance of the model, and I have to import that model class. Now I import it, and what I have to do that I had to initialize that model class before sending a data from front end to the back end. And how I will do that, that I will initialize it using model equal to model, and the name we will add on this controller. So we have to provide the controller name dot text, and inside the phone number we have to provide the controller of the phone number dot text. So now we initialize a model instance. Now we have to pass this model instance inside the HTTP POST method. Inside the HTTP POST method, we have a body parameter. Here we will pass this model instance, but how we will pass it? First, we need to encode this model instance into the JSON string. How? With help of JSON.encode. So basically, the JSON.encode will come using the dart converter, and it will automatically import it for my case when I will use JSON.encode. And for your case also, maybe it will automatically import it. If not imported, then use manually import for importing this. So with help of JSON.encode, we will convert the normal class into the JSON string, and we will use the model instance, and we will use the toJSON method which we created. So let me just help you to understand it. We initialize a model instance where we pass the name and phone number, and with help of toJSON, the mapping will be done. So before sending a JSON data to the backend, we need to map it first. So we need to map the name and phone number corresponding to the name and phone number which we are getting. So with help of toJSON, the mapping will be done, and now it is a normal object. So before sending our data to the backend, we need to convert the normal object into the JSON string. With help of JSON.encode, the conversion of the normal object to the JSON string is done. Now we are ready to hit the add data button. But let me do a one quick thing, that after adding our data, so let me just close it. And after adding a data, what I will do is I will print the data which we will get back from the backend with help of response.body. And I will also want to navigate onto the my app page where I am showing all the data which we are getting back from the backend. So basically in our last video we get a 6th object. When I will add a new object, then the 7th one will become inside the my app class. So let me do that. I will use the navigator to show you navigator dot push, and the context will be same. In the route I have to pass the material route, material page route. In the material page route we have a builder. Inside the builder I have to provide the context. After the context I will provide the page, which is my app page. Now I will hit the save and let's test it. And I have to use this send inside here on place. So I pass the send over here. When I will hit the add data, the data will be sent back to the backend. And let me add a ABC name, and the phone number will be 8975451478. Maybe it's not my number, it's a dummy number. And now we are ready to send this data to the backend. But all the time I told you that we need to add a header also. So never forget to add a header, because if we didn't add a header we will get a error. I mean the data will be now passed successfully to the backend. So always add a header, and inside the header always provide a content type. Don't forget to provide a content type, because it will take you to debug the all the thing whole day. So I will provide a content type as application/json. So let me provide the content type application. JSON and hit the save. Now we are ready. So let me add the data. It will add the data, and now you can see that the 7th data, the ABC and the number is came right now, which means we added a data successfully to the backend. And if you want to check again, let me just refresh it, and we will land into the main.dart file. And let me just provide again another name like test, and 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9. And if I will again click add data, it will land into the my app. And here you can see the 8th object which I added right now, which came here, which means the data which we want to send from the front end to the back end is going successfully, and we are fetching that data in our Flutter app is also reflecting on this page, which means the purpose of this video is now completed. And in the next video I will show you that how we can send a list type of object, I mean list of object, to the backend at the same time, not as a single instance. So suppose I have a 10 of object, and I want to send that 10th object at the same time to the backend. That thing I will show you on a next coming video. So thank you all, happy coding, and see you on the next video. And don't forget to subscribe, like and share the video, because I need your help to grow this channel.